Michael Cowder. I'm the K-12 Director of Performing Arts here in Wellesley, and it is my pleasure to welcome you this evening to Wellesley High School for the Spring Choral Concert. We have an amazing show for you this evening, a performance. Students have worked extremely hard. I'll make our announcements brief. First of all, I want to thank you for being here. A couple of housekeeping things. If you need to leave the auditorium, we ask that you do so in between selections. You need to use the restrooms that are right directly across from the cafeteria. Cell phones, if you could turn the cell phones off and make sure that they are not going to make any sound during the performance this evening, it would be appreciated. If you're taking a picture, we ask that you try to not put it in front of the person in front of you. That would be helpful. I'd like to say a few thanks. First of all, I would like to thank the high school administration here, Dr. Chisholm, the assistant principals and staff, for their continued support. Our community of Wellesley, which we're so fortunate to have such great support for the performing arts here, school committee and a superintendent and central staff. Can we give them all a round of applause and thank them for their continued support? Is, of course, POPS, Parents of Performing Students, who do so many things to support our department, whether it's through thousands of dollars in grants or just helping out with chaperone trips and things like that. POPS is an amazing organization. We're very fortunate to have them. Would you please give POPS a round of applause? We hope you join them. Finally, this evening is not possible without a lot of hard work, but also it just doesn't start at the high school. One of the things that I've done in Wellesley is we really work on a K-12 performing arts program. These students tonight, many of them sang in their elementary, fifth grade choir programs, and those teachers did a tremendous job. Then they moved on to the middle school where they were under the direction of Ms. Lauren Connors, and I believe she's here this evening, and I'd just like to thank her for all she's done to prepare these students. Thank Valerie Stark, who's our accompanist at the middle school, who also helped those students, and I'd like to give Valerie a round of applause and thank her. And finally, our high school staff, and I'm going to introduce them now. We are so fortunate at every level to have such amazing, talented teachers who care deeply about our student success every day and have the highest standards of excellence, and that is truly true tonight. Our two gentlemen who are leading our groups tonight and accompanying are the best around as far as I'm concerned. So first of all, on piano we have the amazing Chad Warwick.
This next piece, Tell My Father, from the musical The Civil War. Civil War was not a particularly successful musical on Broadway, but this song is a very successful song from the musical that was on Broadway. So this is a story of a young man who has died in battle during the Civil War, and he is making a statement of what he wants people to pass on from him to his father. Tell my father.
With honor did I die. Say goodbye. memories. The August moon over a river filled with day dreams.
Feel the sun on your face in the misty night.
And every time I think of you, I dream of our two hearts together.
Many moons ago, when I was working on my dissertation, the topic of vocal jazz became alive to me. Primarily, I studied, and what I did for my dissertation was a direct result of inheriting Ray Street when I first came to Wellesley High School, when I realized I had absolutely no idea how to teach vocal jazz. And that's the absolute truth. So I started a course of study, studied through dissertation, and learned an awful lot. And 15 years later, Rice Street has become really the premier jazz choir in the state of Massachusetts. This next piece is, of all of the jazz standards that are out there, I don't know why, but this one really spoke to me. It's called Ain't Nobody Here But Us Chickens. And yes, it's literally about chickens. But it was so fun that I immediately fell in love with the New York Voices and what they do as a group. Little did I realize that that would cultivate a whole relationship that we've had with that particular group for the last maybe 12 or 13 years. So this is a piece of music I've always wanted to do. It was out of print for many years. Dharma Meter would not give it to me. And finally, it was published and we were able to get it this year. So this is Ain't Nobody Here But Us Chickens, and it's an absolute blast, so enjoy. keynote singers. Just a phenomenal group. They absolutely loved that piece from the first time we played it in class, studying the French, and really just always paying attention to the detail, the dynamics, the like. We have had such a remarkable time this year with the keynote singers. We've had some great musical highs. We've had an incredible positive feeling throughout our classroom. This next piece is a piece of music that we also found. It's Alleluia by Jake Rudisha. Extremely difficult, very fun, and we're just really pleased to be able to present this to you. So this is Alleluia. Thank you. This concert is advertised as our last choral concert of the year. We're going to have a lot of emotion in a little while, and you'll see what I mean. But the good news for the keynote singers is this does not mark their last concert. And if you are enjoying what you are hearing, and especially if you like the first piece by Foray, we are doing a Foray encore, so to speak. And in just a few short weeks, the keynote singers will be performing the Foray Requiem with our Otters Chamber Orchestra at the orchestra concert. So if you look at the Performing Arts website and you see orchestra concert, know that there's a special choral treat also on the program. And that is our keynote singers with the Foray Requiem. Our last piece, as you see in the program, is written by none other than Mr. Chad Wark. This piece of music we've done maybe three or four times in my time at the high school, and it's always just enough times where I haven't done it with a particular group, and they say, we've been waiting to do this piece. So this is by request of the students on stage. This is Daniel Servant Lord, arranged by Chad Wark. too long back, maybe just a month or so, they performed Rent live on TV. I don't know if you saw that or not, but it brought to mind when I asked the students, so I expected everyone to have watched it. And I came in, I'm like, so you won't watch Rent? And almost nobody had watched Rent. This is a musical that I have seen 4 or 5 times. Easy, Will. no intro. No long intro, I suppose. Rent, if you are unfamiliar with the show, was a very controversial show when it first came out. It was a show that dealt with real-life issues in the inner city, poverty, homosexuality, drug use, AIDS, on and on and on. And it was one of the strongest statements of trying to make society look at some of these issues right in front of you. And when you put something on stage in such a huge way, you couldn't help but gather attention. This musical went on to be a hit sensation. And just a few decades later now, it's interesting when I talk to students who are many very much into music theater and had no idea about this show. So I thought it was time to bring this medley back. It's a little bit of a jaunt. I hope you enjoy it. And it's also a very fitting end to our high school career for our seniors, for our time together as a group of singers. By the end, when we start talking about Seasons of Love and No Day But Today, here's Rent.
Yeah.
Opportunity, one song.
Molly Cote. She's one of the co-presidents for COPS. If she could come up here now. Everything you've given all these students, and I'm so thankful that I was